Hello and welcome back everyone to another tutorial on Tableau. This series of videos will help you take your skills from beginner to expert level in Tableau. Do not forget to hit the red subscribe button and the bell icon so that you are the first one to know whenever I upload any new video. In today's session, we will see how to add dynamic up-down arrows in Tableau. Let me show you the demo of what we will be doing today. Here I have a bar chart showing profit ratio of different subcategories. So profit ratio is basically sum of profit divided by sum of sales. So you will observe that whenever the profit ratio is negative, we are getting a down arrow with label and the down arrow both displayed in red. And wherever the profit ratio is positive, there we are getting an up arrow with both the labels and the up arrow displayed in green. These all are the subcategories where the profit ratio is positive. So adding these dynamic up-down arrows clearly gives user the idea where the profit ratio is positive and where the profit ratio is negative. Now let's jump to Tableau and see how to create this type of view. First, let's create a profit ratio calculated field. Click on drop down, select create calculated field. Let's name it profit ratio. And the formula will be sum of profit divided by sum of sales. Click on OK. Now drag subcategory to row shelf. Next, drag the calculated field that we have created, profit ratio, in column shelf. Turn on the labels by clicking show mark labels button. Profit ratio is basically a percentage, so let's change the format to display profit ratio as percentage. Click on format. Under pane, select numbers and select percentage. So here we have a bar chart showing profit ratio for different subcategories. Here you will observe that for subcategories bookcases, then for supplies and tables, the profit ratio is negative and we can see a negative sign before the label. If you need to add the plus sign before the subcategories that have positive profit ratio, so we can add that. So go back to numbers under pane and this time we will select custom. So here we can give the format that we want according to our requirement. Write down here plus semicolon minus 0.00 percentage, then semicolon and hyphen. So first format is for the positive number, then after semicolon, second format is for the negative numbers, and last format is for the numbers which are neither positive nor negative. So here we are telling Tableau to display positive numbers in form of percentage with two decimal places and a plus sign before the positive number. Similarly, in case of negative numbers, we are telling Tableau to display numbers as percentage with two decimal places and add a negative sign before the negative number. So now here you will observe that negative sign is coming before the subcategories which have negative profit ratio, and here we were able to add positive sign before the subcategories where the profit ratio is positive. So we are getting plus sign before each of the labels where the profit ratio is positive. So instead of negative and positive sign, we can also add up and down arrow. Let's now add up and down arrow. First, we will search for the up and down arrows on Google. Let's search for Microsoft Edge. Now, search for alt code. And click on any of the link Now here we will search for the up and down arrow. So here you can see that we have a up arrow and a down arrow. So just click on this and the symbol will be copied. Go back to Tableau. Now under the drop down, go to custom, and for positive we want up symbol, so Control V, and for the negative we want down arrow. So again go back to Google, just click on this down arrow, and again go back to numbers, here Control V. Now here you will observe that we are getting down arrow for the subcategories with negative profit ratio, and for all the subcategories with positive profit ratio we are getting up arrows. So in this way we can add down arrow instead of negative sign and an up arrow instead of positive sign to give user the idea whether the profit ratio is negative or positive. Next, if you also want to change the color of the labels and the sign, like for those bars with positive profit ratio, we want to see up arrow and label in green color. And for all those subcategories with negative profit ratio, we want to see the label and the down arrow in red color. So we will have to create few calculated fields for this. Just close this window. So create a calculated field. Click on create calculate field. Let's name it positive ratio label and write down the formula: if profit ratio is greater than 0, then profit ratio end. Similarly, we will create for negative ratio. Just duplicate this field and let's edit this field, change the name to negative ratio label, and here we will write if profit ratio is less than 0, then profit ratio. So basically we are creating two separate fields for profit ratio labels. Click on OK. Next, create a calculate field. Go to drop down, select create calculate field, and here we will give the name positive ratio sign, and here we will write the formula: if profit ratio is greater than 0, then we will give the symbol within quotes, and we want to see up arrow in case of positive profit ratio. So just go back to Google and copy this up sign and paste here and click on OK. Now similarly we will create one more field for negative ratio sign. Just duplicate this field. Now edit this field. Let's name it negative ratio sign. Remove this copy. Now in this case, if profit ratio is less than 0, we want the down arrow. So we will copy this symbol and paste it here. Click on OK. Now let's change the format of the label fields in terms of percentage. Right click, default properties, number format, and select percentage. Click on OK. Similarly for negative ratio label, we will give the number format as percentage. Click on percentage. Click on OK. Now we will drag these four fields that we have created in labels under mark section. So select all these fields and just drag on the labels. Now to change the colors of these labels, we will go to label and click on three dot next to text. We want to give red color to the negative label. Select from the drop down red color. Next, for the negative ratio sign also we want to display it in red. Select red. Next, for positive label we want to see it as green. Select the green color. And for the positive ratio sign, select again green color. Let's add all these fields in a single line. Now we want the sign to come in the front, so we will arrange the order of these fields. Add this at the starting. First the sign will come, ratio sign, then the negative label. Now here also we will add positive sign before the label. So here we have just changed the order of the fields. So at a time a profit ratio can be either positive or negative. So if the profit ratio is positive, then we will see the positive ratio sign and the positive label. And if the profit ratio is negative, then we will see these two fields where we will get the sign first and next we will get the label. Just click on OK. Now here you will observe that for subcategories with positive profit ratio, we are getting an up arrow with a label, and both the label and the up arrow are displayed in green color. And for these subcategories, bookcases, supplies and tables, where the profit ratio is negative, we are getting a down arrow and both the labels and the down arrow are displayed in red color. So now you will observe that we are not getting the correct tooltips. Let's edit the tooltip in a similar manner as we edited the label. Just go to tooltip. Remove this profit ratio, and we will also remove this heading. Basically here also we will arrange the fields that we have created in a single line in the correct order. So get all these fields in a single line. Now for the subcategories where we have positive profit ratio, we want to see them as green. And for the subcategories where profit ratio is negative, we want to see them in red color. And we want to display the sign before the label, so we will just add it in front of the label. Similarly, for negative ratio sign, we will add it in the front of negative label. Now click on OK. Now you will see that we are getting correct tooltips, and also the formatting is similar to the one displayed next to the bar. And for negative profit ratio, you will observe that we are getting both the labels and down arrow displayed in red, even in the tooltips. So in this way we can add dynamic up down arrows to clearly tell the user where the profit ratio is positive and where the profit ratio is negative. So this was all that I had to cover in this session. I have added the link of this workbook in the description below. Do not forget to hit the thumbs up button if you like this session. Thanks for watching this video. See you in the next session.